The King and I is, and I know this is basically irrelevant, my favorite of the Rodgers and Hammerstein shows. It's the first one I ever saw at the Music Theater of Lincoln Center with Darren McGavin and Reese Stevens, another recording that exists. There's something about The King and I that I just find majestically wonderful. First of all, it's a very interesting story. The history tells us that the King Mongkut of Siam, while he watched countries around his area be conquered, asked for a British school teacher to come to teach his children in order for him to figure out what the Western mentality was so he wouldn't be conquered. There is a false sense in some people today that the story of The King and I is the West coming to turn the East right, the backwards East, make it more of a part of a modern world. That's not at all the story. The story is that he was smart enough to ask for this. What makes The King and I a good story is the fact that he then falls for this cantankerous woman, because of course, from a feminist standpoint, the King of Siam has promised her a house of her own, and he just dismisses it. You know, and the whole first act is, you know, she keeps saying, you promised me a house, you'll stay in palace, you'll be in palace, you'll live, work in palace, you'll stay in palace. You know, and this woman is still, I mean, he's the King of Siam, for God's sake. But, you know, she says, he made me a promise. I don't care who he is, he made me a promise. And of course, it makes for the most extraordinary denouement of the first act, because she's helping him get all the preparations ready for the English who are now going to come, and he's ordering everybody around. And at the moment when you least expect it, and he has ordered her, her head is not to be higher than his, and you can tell she's sort of seething and thinks, oh, I'll deal with this later. And at the moment you least expect it, he says, and give her the house. That's great theater. That's great drama. And it's also one of those sort of anti-love stories, where the audience is light years ahead of the two characters who are doing everything in their power to keep their distance. The fact that one of the sexiest moments in all of musical theater is the moment where the King of Siam comes over and puts his hand on Mrs. Anna's waist in preparation for doing that sexy dance, the polka. That's theater magic. The fact that they could write this story so that the mere act of doing that and doing that, and in a good production of The King and I, the audience is like, oh, you can feel chills in it. That's good theater storytelling.